Ting in the black trunks, Folayang in the red. Flying knee from the Malaysian, but Folayang brings him down.
Folayang with the takedown on Ting, and the shocks continue from Team Lakai.
Right hand from Folayang. Something reminiscent about the way he finished the Hokie there for a moment. But Ting got through it and he's back on his feet. Or left hand followed up by a right. Didn't land solidly.
Good head movement by Ev Ting to stay just out of range of that slip right down the midline.
Good punches from Ev Ting. And you'll notice that Ting never backs off, but he gets sent backwards from that right hand. Spinning back kick, which is Folayang's signature move. He likes the spinning back fist too.
This crowd is anticipating fireworks here tonight in the packed MOA Arena. Folayang looks relaxed and composed.
Listen to this crowd mix. They are right behind their man, and that is what Ev Ting is up against, not just his opponent.
Ev Ting needs to settle down, relax, get his composure back. Kind of adjust to that onslaught thrown early by Folayang.
He'll always stay right there, Ev Ting, won't he?
Yeah, he just stays in the pocket, though, because he can't stay in the pocket with Folayang, because once he starts spinning, that's just going to be his kind of his signature to how relaxed he gets. But good head movement by Ev Ting. He's been able to avoid some punches and also avoid some of these big kicks.
Has he got the speed, the Malaysian, to deal with Folayang? He's got the power.
Folayang used to, Ev Ting used to fight at featherweight, so he's used to dealing with smaller, faster opponents, so I don't think the speed is going to be there. But the explosiveness of Folayang is something that's going to be tough to deal with.
You'll see this pattern probably throughout the fight. Ting in the center of the cage, Folayang circling around it, taking the outside perimeter there.
Ev Ting stands a bit flat-footed in his stance, and you can see that Folayang is always light on his toes, consistently moving around.
Yeah, always on the ball of his feet, isn't he? Looking to unleash that kick.
See, now Folayang's starting to spin, and that's how you can tell.
He caught that kick and then sent in a huge right hand that did not connect. He put everything into that.
Ev Ting's got to start mixing this up. He does not want to stand there in front of Folayang and let him start unloading some of these shots. He's got to mix in the takedowns, threaten the submissions, get Folayang something else to think about.
Both men with very, very strong legs. Think of the power and the kicks they can unleash.
Tornado kick coming from the Malaysian.
A little bit over-elaborate, maybe.
Both these guys know that this is their shot at history in the making. So they're trying to put on their best show possible. All the video game moves are going to be coming out tonight.
History is right here. 20,000 fans in the Mall of Asia Arena. Manny Pacquiao in attendance. Celebrities and champions everywhere you look. Ting always wide-eyed, looking intensely into the eyes of his opponent. There's that spinning back fist that did not connect, but he's looking for it, and he'll look again, you can be sure of that.
That's what I like to see from Ting. When Folayang spins, close the distance, get tight on him, and drag this fight to the ground. Make him think about different level changes, mix things up a bit, keep him guessing. Ev Ting's got so many different weapons.
Kick to the midriff, just dropped Ting for a moment, but he sprung back up like a jack in a box.
1 minute left in the first round. 1 minute.
Ting will stand there, he'll shuffle forward. There's no retreat in this man. He takes a kick to the belly, though.
They don't look to catch him kind of on the elbows. Deflected just slightly there. But this is Folayang's fight. This is what he likes to do. He likes to stand there and pick his opponents apart at that kicking range.
Folayang's body already glistening with sweat, which means it'll be difficult to get any purchase on him should Ting try to grapple with him. But you fancy much of this fight is going to be, as we see it, standing up toe-to-toe, kicking and punching. And Folayang unleashes a wild right hand that, again, doesn't quite connect. Big right hand from Ting, and he missed with the left too. But these two are prepared to fire bombs. That was 5 minutes where the edge of your seat took a fair bit of weight.
Let's take a look at some of that past action of that round. We saw exactly what a lot of people thought, a mixed bag of striking skills shown by both these fighters. Ev Ting got a little bit overzealous, went for a flying knee, fully able to spin him around and take him down. And there are some of those spinning attacks Folayang is known for. When he starts to spin around like that helicopter, you know some creativity is on the way. Rich Franklin, break that down.
Well, although I have Edward scored on the takedown at the beginning of the round, most of the scoring in this round has been in the striking superiority category. But it's razor close. You know, Edward's exploding using his footwork, coming back and forth. Ev's doing a good job of covering up, so he's not taking a lot of damage. But when those combos, when they get dirty on the inside, the occasional punch here and there, kick is landing from Folayang. So I have him just slightly ahead on the scorecards.
We said that the experts were really split in this one in terms of who wins, but a lot of people think that it could go the distance. So we'll come back to Rich Franklin at the end of every round and get his assessment of who's ahead. Fight scored in their entirety, not round by round here at ONE Championship. One round in the books, this five-minute round. So 25 minutes of action if they go the distance.
There he is. Good single leg. Snatches the leg up lightning fast, but good defense from Folayang.
That's what they've got good at in the last few months, right?
Folayang doesn't really use the offensive wrestling like Bonario does, but he uses his wrestling skills, his newly acquired wrestling skills, to stop takedowns and make his opponents punish for it.
Just for a moment there, Folayang going for the single leg himself.
It made me almost look bad there. It almost made me eat my words a little bit.
Spinning each other around so they share time with their back against the cage. At the moment, it's Ting pressing Folayang, sending in a knee to the thigh, takes one back. Left hand from Ting. There's been some big, big punches thrown, but not much in terms of connection. And there's a good example for you.
That was beautiful. Slid under the spinning back fist, attempted a double leg, but Folayang did exactly it. His puzzle is getting harder and harder to solve. It's so difficult to take him down. The legend Aoki had a hard time with it, couldn't hold him down. He was able to pop right back up. Ev Ting spent a lot of time out there in Bali working with the Leone brothers, but he also spends a lot of time at his home club, Auckland MMA in New Zealand. So he gets a lot of different partners to help prepare him for this world title fight.
That fight against Aoki was a big night for Folayang, but this must be the biggest night of his life, defending the title in front of his home fans. This is what he must have dreamt about his entire career. It's happening right now for him. He's got to seize the moment.
Good combination for Folayang to go high with the high kick and then right down to low to go after the leg.
Folayang just got his left arm up in time to check that kick. He comes back with a spinner of his own, but these big punches and big kicks not connecting yet.
Man, if one of them does,
yeah, it's a matter of time, isn't it?
Wow, these guys are throwing some serious heat with their legs.
Oh, he really loaded up on that one, but Ting got his left arm up just in time and moved his head backwards and out of the way.
Keeping that guard high is going to be so important in this fight because these kicks are coming with some serious speed.
Good
nice
jab
right
from
hand.
Yeah, he got caught though.
He got connected on the jab like you said, but got caught with a right hand by Ting. Tried to catch that kick again, but Ting did the right thing by ducking out of the way.
Well, they're starting to land now, aren't they?
They're both getting so comfortable and relaxed in there.
Ting slips, I think. Listen to the crowd as they see a window of opportunity, but Ting hops out of it, and we're back on our feet. Intense attention from the 20,000 here at the Mall of Asia Arena. At times they've been deafeningly loud, at other times, like just at the moment, they just can't take their eyes off the action.
Nice little back elbow, back fist, kind of slowed my
Folayang. Missed with a straight right and then just came back at him on the way out again.
I love Folayang's creativity.
Yeah.
1 minute.
9 minutes down.
You gotta wonder, does this constant forward pressure have any effect on the aggression of the fight? But the way that Folayang counter punches and initiates attacks from the back foot is kind of negates the aggression of Ting consistently moving forward.
Just before they got into this clinch, Ev Ting threw a nice right uppercut that did land. First one we've seen from him in this fight. That could be a dangerous weapon.
Ting's been landing a couple of these big punches. Not really looking to change levels. See how Folayang has that overhook wrapped underneath the arm of Ting? That's helping control his posture so Ting can't drop down and go after the legs.
Two rounds in the book. We'll get to Rich Franklin shortly for his assessment as to who's in front. And the man who wins it will be presented with the belt by that man, Manny Pacquiao. Will be in the cage at the end of the fight.
Let's look at some of this second round. Big strikes just barely missing by both fighters. Ting went high, slight slip, trying to transition into a single leg, but Folayang ended up on the back, and both fighters scrambled back up to their feet. Big strikes barely missing there by Folayang. There's that clash of the heads you were speaking about. But this fight is just a bunch of narrow misses, Steve. Rich, what do you got?
Well, this fight's all about the stand-up game here, striking superiority. That last highlight is a telltale story. You know, when Folayang throws a combination, he'll come out and even do something awkward, like a back fist and score there. In these little dirty boxing exchanges, he's landing a bit more of the punches. Ev Ting's, the strikes that he's landing, they're like one-offs. A good right hand here, a body kick there. But most of the body kicks, Edward's still catching. I have Edward even inching a little bit further ahead, but still, this is a very close fight at this point.
Well, this point is the 10-minute mark. There are 15 minutes to go. Plenty of time for Ev Ting to overcome the slight lead that Rich Franklin says Folayang has.
Again, more of the same that we saw in the second round. Ev Ting controlling the center of the cage, Folayang slipping back and forth, left and right, very subtly, but just enough so that Ev Ting can't get a read on his position.
Folayang ducked under that huge left hand from Ev Ting, who at the moment fighting southpaw, that left hand is the big bomb from that stance.
But when you miss those big punches and those big kicks, it takes energy out of you. You lose a little bit of confidence and a little bit of just that will, because you're like, oh, yeah, everything was put into that punch and then just barely slides out of the way.
Oh, right hand from Edward, and that rocked Ev Ting. And now he has to clinch. Turns his man around and presses him up against the cage. Perhaps the first big punch of the fight, certainly the biggest somebody's cut, and it's Folayang, I think.
You watch these two exchange, and everybody kind of just holds their breath, and a hush falls over because they're waiting for something gigantic to happen.
I can't quite confirm that it is Folayang who's cut. There's some blood coming from somewhere.
Good knees to the body by the champion. Ooh. Again, a big miss from the kick.
I think that cut is above Edward's right eyebrow. He gets a kick in the face. Now, what effect will this have on the fight? We've already seen Edward dab the blood away. If it's above the eye, the blood will run into the eye, and that will compromise his vision. We're not even at the halfway mark in this fight, so that is a problem for him.
Ah, nice change of levels there by Ting to go for the high crotch now. I like how Edward's trying to push the head up of Ev Ting, not allowing him to get fully under there to change the level to go to finish this takedown.
Action!
And this is kind of the fight that all the pundits have been talking about, Steve. Everybody's just kind of been saying that they expected this to be a five-round war of attrition, consistently battling back and forth. And both fighters are so close in so many categories that, I And you were seeing a lot of stalemates happen, especially when things get up against the cage.
Oh, flying attack from Ev Ting.
He loves that flying knee, doesn't he, Steve?
You're talking about this one being a war of attrition, Mitch. Remember, Folayang is 6 years older, but cardio is not an issue for him. He's always in great shape, training up there in the altitude of Baguio City.
More growing, keep going. Watch out.
Ting doing the pressing, pushing Folayang back to the cage. And the Filipino breaks free, spinning back fist. And Ev Ting sticks his tongue out to say, is that all you've got? Show me some more.
11 of Folayang's 22 fights have gone to a decision, so he is used to going the full five rounds. Ev Ting never been past the third round.
Inside the final 90 seconds of the third round. So we're over the halfway mark.
A lot of cage battling up in here against them, that clinch position. This is draining. A lot of fight fans don't necessarily understand the intricacies of the clinch game in here. These subtle little knees that they're throwing can deaden the legs. That's gonna have an effect in the championship rounds.
So Yuji separates them and brings them back to the center of the cage so they can begin again.
1 minute left.
Looking to land that sort of lengthy left hook. Left, right from Folayang, follows up with a second left hand, and they scored nicely. Right hand from the champion.
I like how he throws that kick, misses the kick, but follows it up with that big looping right hand.
And I think both his feet were off the ground when that landed, Mitch.
That was
Superman-esque.
Ting keeps his hands really low, likes to punch from that upward position. Folayang's got a little bit higher guard.
Looks in good control, Ev Ting. Perhaps slightly behind. We'll get to Rich's opinion on that shortly, but he's very much in this, the Malaysian.
Used a spinning wheel kick to kind of pass by the guard, clinch up into the back. The third round was more of the same that we've seen from the second and the first round. There's Team Lakai celebrating, holding the gold in the air. Let's go back and take a look at some of the action in the third round. There's a body kick thrown by Ting. And Ting loves to take to the air with that flying knee. This one actually landed, connecting with the body of Folayang, able to get into the clinch. There's that big punching combination, the 1-2 and the hook. Here's that flying punch. Are we gonna see it? Oh, we just missed that in the feet air. Rich, what do you got?
Well, again, like you said, much of the same as in the first rounds, first and second round. This is all about striking superiority. You know, I had Ev actually closing the distance in that fight. It was almost dead even, and then, of course, like with about a minute left, Folayang landed that combination and kind of rocked him a little bit. I have both these guys actually scored in the damage category. You can see the cut on Falayang's face. Ev has kind of been wobbled a little bit here and there. Nothing major, but just some honorable mentions in that category, we'll say. As of right now, I still have just Folayang edging this out, barely.
What you could see in the close-up between rounds there was, yes, there's the cut above Folayang's eye, but there's a swelling underneath it, and they put the little... the iron air that lives in the ice bucket just to try and reduce that swelling in the limited time that they have between rounds. We're into the fourth. The championship rounds. Overhand right there from Folayang. Lands high on the top of Ev Ting's head. Slamming leg to the thigh. Folayang looks the quicker of the two.
Yeah, Folayang has a little bit of damage under his eye, but I mean, you would, from the way that he's moving, you would think this is the first round. He's moving so precisely and fast. And he's landing strikes, kind of inching away in that striking superiority that Rich Franklin was talking about earlier.
And you seem to notice in all fights, once Edward gets going and gets this movement where he moves his hands up and down and he moves left and to the right and then he spins, and it's perpetual motion for him. He gets in a groove and just keeps coming at you. And that's when Ev Ting should concentrate very hard.
But he's not a stationary target, Steve. He never stands in one place. That those little subtle moves, that hand gyration as he's popping up and down. He's not a stationary target. It's very hard to pinpoint exactly where he's gonna be. And he's throwing strikes constantly from that movement.
Ev Ting is in a little bit of trouble in the back there, but that's a very nice touch.
I like the scissor takedown from Ev Ting to get into a possible heel hook there. He's got to extend his legs out.
He's working very hard on it. He's let go with his left hand.
The only successful takedown of the fight is a very unorthodox move.
It was very skillful indeed. But Ting now is up against it, pressed it first against the mat, and now the cage wall. Folayang is strong. Remember, Ting came up from featherweight, may not be as naturally strong as Folayang, who's practiced at lightweight seemingly all his career, and fits that weight very, very well with that muscular body of his. The unforgiving Yuji Shimada calls for more action at the 2.5 minute mark of the fourth round.
But both these guys are throwing, they're being active inside the clinch, but Yuji Shimada wants more. I think he's enjoying the stand-up game just as much as every other person in this packed arena.
118 countries around the world, potentially over 1 billion viewers, 20,000 of them packed into the Mall of Asia Arena. Enjoying this one. The most important fight in either of these two fighters' career.
Ev Ting's lost about a half step, but he's consistently keeps his game plan in place by moving forward. But just the volume of strikes thrown by Folayang.
That looked like a dangerous move for Ev Ting for a moment there, but Folayang moved just at the last moment and turned it into an advantageous move for himself.
Looks to be a bit of a swelling underneath the right eye of Ev Ting. Probably caused by the fast hands of Folayang early in that third, or later in that third round.
Ev Ting drops his hands and
he's standing in the middle of the cage waiting for Folayang to come to him.
He wants him to come forward, doesn't he?
But that's not Edwards' style. He should know that. Folayang is not going to be tricked or manipulated into breaking his game plan. He's too strong of a mental warrior for that.
Shoulder in the belly. Drop down. Shoulder in the belly. Drop down. Finish.
Final 50 seconds of the fourth round. This is where the story gets written in earnest. If this one goes the distance, as a lot of people think it will, this is where the points start to get racked up. As fatigue sets in, who can take advantage?
Good. Ting's really applying pressure with his head and his shoulder to just smush Eduard Folayang up against the cage there. He's trying to change levels. He's trying to drop down. But that overhook with Folayang's left arm is preventing Ting from really dropping down and attacking the legs. And he keeps pushing the head back up.
Eduard left and right as he comes off the cage wall. Now fighting open mouth, the spinning kick to the torso pushes Ev Ting back. And that's the fourth round in the books. 20 minutes down, 5 to go, and this crowd are loving it. There's Jehe Eustaquio, there's Manny Pacquiao. And he's watching all of the action very closely. This is what he saw in the fourth.
Look at that beautiful scissor takedown to get Folayang to the mat, which set up a nice little transition into a possible heel hook. But Folayang kept it nice and tight, grabbing the head, not allowing Ting to extend out to lock that in fully. Rich. Break it down.
Well, I'll tell you what, I pulled up my takedowns in this particular round because it shows how comfortable Ev Ting is in this fight to be able to drop for a scissor takedown like that and look for a heel hook this late in fight. They're sweaty, that's a gutsy move, but I gotta say though, Eduard was still able to consistently land the leg kicks, throw a few jabs in there, and even though Ev is controlling the cage and pushing Eduard against the cage, I still think he's doing more damage in the clinch. So even though Ting is winning that category of the takedown, my overall score still has Folayang barely ahead. And this is anybody's fight still.
What does Ting have to do in this round to take the belt?
He's gonna have to do some damage, you know, some significant damage, because even something like that heel hook, it wasn't in tight enough for me to actually score that to a near submission. So he's gonna have to really do some damage in this round.
And this is the final round. Ev Ting, the challenger. Eduard Folayang, the champion. Folayang slightly ahead on Rich Franklin's scorecard. How will the judges see it? What will happen in the next 4.5 minutes or so?
Yeah, Ev Ting's gonna have to put the heat on Folayang if he's gonna wanna walk away out of this arena with that belt. He's trying to change it up, trying to go after that takedown still, because he's just not winning the stand-up the way that I'm sure he wanted to.
He's probably gonna need to dominate this final 5 minutes in fairly significant fashion to persuade the judges that he's worthy of having his hand raised.
You know, see, that's the beauty of this judging, the scoring system that we have. The fight is judged on its entirety. So you could, you know, in theory, lose each one of the rounds or the fight so far, but have a tremendous upstart back in the fifth round and take the win home. Or you can, but also, Ting possesses that unique ability to knock out his opponents, which is a definite test and an attribute that very few have.
Well, the crowd here will have been looking forward to this for a number of weeks. They all bought their tickets and sold out fairly quickly. Couldn't get a ticket for love nor money today, that's for sure. Left, right from Folayang. Ting comes back with an exchange of his own. Not as accurate as the Filipino's punches, though. Sends in a couple of short left hooks in the clinch there, Ev Ting.
That's what he's got to do more of. When he gets in these clinch, use those short, dirty punches to get in close and also to score some points.
We're approaching the final 3 minutes. Folayang's cardio, famously well capable of seeing out what's left.
Oh! Ting goes headhunting. Folayang throws him down to the mat. Doesn't want to go to the ground with Ting. Allows him to pop back up.
Yeah. He's had the edge in the stand-up. No reason to get down there and risk anything. Sends in that kick and it raises the leg of Ev Ting's trunk and reveals a very red thigh that's been battered by that right kick.
I felt that leg kick. That one stung.
Ting maintains the center of the cage, continues to be wide-eyed and at times wide-mouthed. Right hand from Eduard.
Eduard's even slowed down a little bit. You know, you can't leave this in the hands of the judges. Who knows what these three gentlemen on cage side are thinking? You never want to leave it to the hands of the judges when something as important as a world title is on the line.
Stabbing left leg into the thigh of Ev Ting. He switches starts back and forwards, and Folayang comes at it again. Just stabs with the sole of that foot heavily onto the thigh. Minute and three quarters left. The man who beat Shinya Aoki, who took his belt with a spinning back fist, and that one landed flush. Ev Ting says, come on, come at me. If you're a fighter, let's see it happen. That was not well greeted by the fans here at the Mall of Asia Arena.
They want, Ting wants him to stand in the middle and trade. But Folayang, he's, see, again, he's not being manipulated into this game. He stays with his game plan, continues to circle out.
It's very unlikely that that game of taunting will work for Ev Ting. Folayang knows that he's got just over a minute to continue doing what he's doing to the sound of uproarious chants from the fans. Folayang, Folayang. Inside the final minute now, and the crowd are on their feet applauding the effort of these two warriors. Folayang continues to circle the cage. Ting gets bustled against the cage and receives two right hands to the face in the process. Ting spins him round. He's got to do something very special now in the final half minute if he's going to take this fight.
I think Ting's going to be setting up something huge here. He's got to try something. He's got to win by knockout in the last 20 seconds.
Folayang, center of the cage. sends that foot into the torso. Flying knee from Ev Ting, the crowd on their feet again. Left hand from the Malaysian, misses with the uppercut. Final seconds of this World Championship contest. Folayang will get a huge roar from the fans as this bell goes. The decision awaits, but Folayang already has his hands in the air, as do the Filipino fans. It's clear to them who they think has won. And as I look up at Ev Ting with his hands on his head, you get the suspicion that he may be thinking exactly the same thing. Mitch Chilson.
There was a huge head kick landed by Ev Ting, but Folayang took it, caught it, threw Ev Ting to the ground with it. There's those stomping leg kicks to the thigh of Ev Ting thrown by Folayang, and landing a spinning back fist. The striking superiority clearly on display in the fifth and final round. Again with the spinning back fist. Caught the flying knee and answers with his signature spinning moves. Rich, what do you got?
I have these guys dead even in aggression. Folayang won the takedown category, but the striking superiority, he clearly took that category barely, but you can see even with that last replay, the spinning elbow that landed there, that's the story of what's going on. These guys basically had the same amount of superficial damage. I would give this decision to Eduard Folayang.
You heard Rich Franklin, it's Folayang's decision, but Dom has the official word.
To present the belt for this fight, we have Tina Xie, Senior Marketing Manager for GoDaddy Asia, Mr. Victor Kui, CEO of ONE Championship, and Mr. Manny Pacquiao, World Champion and ONE Championship Shareholder. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of intense battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this fight in favor of your winner, and still one lightweight champion of the world, Eduard Folayang!
It's Folayang versus Atlan Gedeon. Folayang wants to put himself back into contention for the world title in the lightweight division, held by Martin Nguyen.
Atlan Gedeon has really good boxing. He likes to open up with kicks, and he's kind of unpredictable when it comes to his striking patterns. But when you talk about unpredictable, how can you predict how Folayang is going to spin on you?
Atlan Gedeon undefeated, 11-0, but he has never competed on a stage as big as ONE Championship.
And I don't think he's ever had an opponent quite like the Landslide.
Folayang, a tentative start, a filling out process from the Filipino. You can imagine everyone in Baguio City, the Philippines at the moment, is watching this one on ABS-CBN Sports in Action and cheering on Eduard Folayang.
Folayang opens up with a nice little leg kick there. You can hear that ricochet around the stadium.
Folayang, rock solid, built of granite. Wushu martial artist throws the inside thigh kick. Jab body shot, tries to put the belly button through the back. Controlling center cage here for Liang.
Atlan Gedeon is usually the one pushing forward and taking the center cage. And you can see he's going back now. He's the one being pushed up against the cage. Okay.
What worries me here for Atlan Gedeon is he is drifting into the power side of Folayang. You see Folayang's trying to force him to his right. That's the power right hand, the power right leg of the Filipino. There he goes again.
He's cutting that corner very well.
Perfect game so far from Eduard Folayang. Fakes there from the former champion. Has the Russian on the outside. No chance for Atlan Gedeon to use his championship sambo so far. Big outside leg kick from Folayang. I like this cerebral start from Folayang. There's a spinning hook kick from Atlan Gedeon.
Atlan Gedeon is the one spinning first, which surprises me. Nice little push kick, though, as a defensive weapon there to defend the kick.
Jab to right roundhouse kick, put the forearm to the Russian.
Atlan Gedeon is playing Folayang's game. This is what Folayang wants to do. He wants to get comfortable, wants to get relaxed, and basically just have target practice.
Folayang cuts off the cage and almost cuts off his head with that side kick. Beautifully done from the Filipino. Now north-south position. Back to their feet. Show of power, show of strength. Who will win the tussle? Atlan Gediev upends himself after throwing an elbow. Oh, the left hook from Folayang.
Nice little duck under from Atlan Gediev to end up in top. Possible guillotine, but his leg is just holding the head there. Chooses to let it go. Now he's going after a Kimura. He's going to have to turn his hips all the way to the side. He uses it to sweep Atlan Gediev. That is beautiful.
Folayang in full mount of the undefeated Russian. And now the ground and pound for the former world champion. Atlan Gediev gives his back. The hooks are in here from Folayang. He flattens him out like a Russian pancake. Will he try to sink the choke? He may soften him up a little more.
Dropping a little bit of ground and pound. Folayang's trying to make quick work. Good control of the posture of Atlan Gediev as he tried to reach up and get a body lock. This is veteran experience right here from Folayang.
Look at Folayang taking his time, picking his shots, looking for the opening, being methodical with his ground and pound. And Atlan Gediev got no place to go right in front of our Chinese commentary team.
Atlan Gediev's trying to go out the back door. He needs to push off the legs a little bit, but Folayang's heavy hips are making that very impossible. Those thunderous legs of his are not only good for kicking, but they're also good for control. But look at Atlan Gediev, big bridge out. One momentary minor mistake from Folayang cost him a very valuable position.
The Sambo champion now in top position, gets to his feet, tries to rain down the ground and pound. Folayang glances towards his corner, puts him inside the closed guard, not allowing Atlan Gediev to posture up and land those massive meat hooks.
Look for Folayang trying to look after that arm. So you see him trying to lean to that left side as he throws up an arm bar there. Folayang's been spending a lot of time on his jiu-jitsu game.
Said he puts a lot of work into the ground game. Always knew how strong Atlan Gediev was on the ground. But said he was unfazed to go there, and certainly looks that way. Folayang back to his feet now. That is the first round. What a ripper here in Singapore.
Here's Folayang controlling the distance. Just barely glanced off the side of the head with the heel of his foot in that side kick. That led to the ground position. Here's Folayang dropping a little bit of ground and pound. Right here, right after that, was the moment Atlan Gediev bridged out of it and was able to create a little bit of a scramble there. And finished that round at least in a better position. Folayang's looking real sharp.
Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, and if you're watching live on our brand new One Championship Super app, hope you're enjoying it. One Championship, unstoppable dreams. Look, from the Singapore Indoor Stadium, a sellout crowd in this massive arena. We were sold out more than a week ago. It is the hottest ticket in town. One Championship is alive and happening. Second round. Fantastic opening round, Mitch.
Atlan Gediev just looked over at us and gave us a nice little wink to let us know he's okay.
Folayang did a lot right in that opening stanza. Forced Atlan Gediev to go into his power side, and you see the Russian drifting there again. Skip up outside leg kick from Folayang. Controlling center cage, jab to the sternum, right to the breadbasket, both missed the target. Oh, that was an overhand right, went higher than my cholesterol. Beautifully done, the wushu styling from Folayang.
You can see a little bit of superficial damage starting to build on the left side of Atlan Gediev's face. Some of those massive meat hooks of Folayang. It could have been that push kick, actually, that glanced off the side of his face with that heel.
Folayang looking superb right now. The size of the Filipino, no ring rust, a very cerebral but powerful performance. Cracking outside thigh kick reverberated around this massive arena.
But it's only been 6 months since Folayang's last contest where he went up against Martin Nguyen and lost the lightweight strap. So that had had to be so important for him to get back in here and do well tonight against a tough, undefeated athlete.
You know that this is the most stacked card in ONE Championship history when Eduard Folayang is the second belt on the card.
Yeah.
A man who is usually main event anywhere else.
Folayang is a massive superstar right under Manny Pacquiao in the Philippines. I can just imagine every single Filipino is on the Super app watching this contest right now.
And you know, Mitch, you live there in Manila, you know just how big Eduard is. And if they're watching live on ABS-CBN Sports in Action, I know they're all on the edge of their seats for Eduard Folayang. Fake there from the Russian, fakes again, throws the overhand right. Bolo punch, cutting side kick from Folayang.
Of Eduard Folayang just to shrug off Atlan Gediev like that.
The Philippine martial arts machine, top position again. 2 minutes 45 remaining, second round of three. Knees from Folayang. Look at the imprint of Folayang's foot on the thigh of Atlan Gediev from the leg kicks. Nice knee between the eyes, sprawls out Folayang.
Atlan Gediev searching for the single. Good defense from Folayang, really controlling the top position well. This type of wrestling, this type of top control is actually what got him the lightweight belt in the first place.
Up. Won the lightweight championship, of course, by defeating the great Shinya Aoki. Did Eduard Folayang. Shinya Aoki is next up on our card. He takes on a Russian in Russell Yakyayev. Folayang, this is one of the smartest strategies I've seen from Folayang. Controlling center cage, forcing Atlan Gediev to the outside, and making the Russian go where he leads him, where he draws him.
Throws that jab, sets up that straight body punch, or he's possibly looking for that big side kick that he likes so much.
Cracking leg kick, Atlan Gediev checks it. Folayang, patient in the striking. Picks the opening, lands the strike, moves out of counter range. And again, does so with a head kick. Two-punch combination. Defends the single leg attempt from Atlan Gediev. There's a big right hand, smack down to the beard.
Folayang mixing up the weapons really well. Jab to the head, straight to the body, goes in for the takedown, ends back up on top and just trying to smother Atlan Gediev. Atlan Gediev's trying to defend, trying to get that right, that left knee into position, but, oh, he's... Folayang slides in the mount, well done.
Gets the back now of the Russian. Can he put the hooks in and flatten him out? No, chooses to stand.
Interesting.
He's going to allow Atlan Gediev up, maybe sling the legs a little first, maybe look to pass. He's going to let him up. 45 seconds on the clock.
Had a dominant position there, Michael, in the back. Could have just chose to go on a knee ride, but chose to let him go and let this thing back up to the feet. I think Folayang sees something here.
Eduard Folayang driving traffic at the moment, and the traffic is headed to Manila. Actually headed to Baguio City. This big wild overhand from Atlan Gediev proving useless.
Big stoppage, like just running into a brick wall. Folayang got the underhook, stopped him right in his tracks. Says, nope, stand up to where I want to be.
Just the build on Folayang, such an imposing figure. This is another round. Mitch, if you're in the corner of Atlan Gediev, what are you telling the Russian to do?
First of all, he's got to stop circling to the power side of Folayang. He's got to change things up, change directions, start circling to the right into the left hand. But by circling into the left hand, you're spinning, you're circling into the side that Folayang likes to spin to. So you're kind of, it's a double-edged sword with the circling. Do you go to the power side or do you go to the spinning side of Folayang? So it's a conscious decision on Atlan Gediev to choose to circle to the power and not to the spin.
Comments from the Dragon, Mitch Chilson, cage side with myself, Michael Chiavello. Third and final round of this lightweight contest in which Eduard Folayang of the Philippines and the red trunks is in control. Goes to the body of the Russian as he has for the previous two rounds. Spinning heel kick there, unsuccessful for Atlan Gediev. Good sprawl to defend the takedown from Folayang.
Beautifully done. Got the hands nice and low, just stopped him right in his tracks.
Folayang rips up that head kick, hoping for the headache maker.
See, this is the cage control of Folayang. He's stepping slightly to the left here, trying to bait Atlan Gediev to move to his left, and then he can set up some of that big right hand as he's going to the body, going to the head, and throwing leg kicks, slowing him down.
I am so impressed by the strategy, the performance of Folayang. Throws that Wushu sidekick again, went to the jaw that time.
Atlan Gediev's got to change the distance. He's got to change the tempo, because right now he's being lured into the... Oh, there you go. Now he comes charging forward, right as I said it. But that's what he has to keep doing. Keep pushing Folayang. Create some other things other than just circling to that side and letting Folayang just let go on it.
Overhand right from the Russian. That was a little bitter. It's time to pull out the stops. It's time to throw caution to the wind. Inside thigh kick from Folayang. Outside thigh kick Folayang to that common peroneal nerve. This is just Eduard Folayang at his very best. Not only a superstar in the Philippines, but popular wherever we go around Asia. Everybody loves Eduard Folayang.
He's so entertaining. He always puts on a show, whether it's highlight reel knockouts or exceptional performances. He's always putting on a show.
But he also the values he brings, Mitch, the true martial arts Bushido spirit, the integrity, the honor. All the values of a true martial artist are embodied in Eduard Folayang.
Michael Cervello getting a little deeper, going on the inside. I was focusing on the outside of Overseer, but I do like that point.
Eduard edges forward again, spinning back first. And a roundhouse kick.
If we notice, Folayang hasn't spun much. He hasn't set up that spinning sidekick, that thing that he likes so much, but that's what Nguyen caught him with, is he stepped to the side and threw that big right hand. So maybe that's a decision as well, not to spin as much because he doesn't want to get caught in the open.
Oh, there it is, he must have heard you, turning back into the liver. How about that?
Almost on cue.
You know who's one of the biggest Eduard Folayang fans going around? Martin Nguyen always tweets and Facebooks about Eduard Folayang. Loves watching Folayang.
Very true. I think everybody does. Good defense here. Alan Gediev trying to go for that single leg again, but good hip. Look at the pressure from his hips as he's sprawling down heavy.
Under 2 minutes remaining. Say, Kumastas Kababayan to all the fans in the Philippines. 1 minute 40 away from a Eduard Folayang victory here. Unless the Russian Atlan Gediev can find a way to swing the pendulum in his favor. Another cutting sidekick from Folayang.
Don't count Atlan Gediev out. He's undefeated for a reason. He still packs power in those punches.
Ooh, look at that. Here come the turning kicks. Another sidekick from Folayang. But as we saw earlier, Atlan Gediev has never been on a stage this big. And they don't come any bigger than one championship. The largest martial arts organization on the planet.
Moving forward with a big left hook.
Almost an outside crescent kick there from Folayang. 1 minute remaining now. Folayang controlling center cage as he has throughout the entire contest. Big outside leg kick, sprawls out once more. This is superb from Eduard Folayang.
Again, he throws that leg kick. He initially gets a shot from Gediev and sprawls heavy.
And you hear the chance for Folayang going up in Singapore.
You can see Atlan Gediev getting a little bit frustrated.
30 seconds now for Atlan Gediev to find something. There's that outside hooking kick again from Folayang. What a show he has put on. A striking clinic from the former world champion. And Atlan Gediev a little gassed. Momentarily, the hands went on the knees. He fakes the Russian. He's going to hope for a Hail Mary shot now. He tries one with a jumping fourth right hand. It's not going to happen for Atlan Gediev. It is going to happen for Eduard Folayang. The Filipino will be back in the winner's circle.
It looked like Eduard Folayang was trying a Peruvian necktie there at the end of the round, putting all his tools on display, but putting on a very impressive show. Here's that spinning back kick right to the lat there of Atlan Gediev as Atlan Gediev tries to go for the single leg, but good overall performance in cage control, striking superiority, takedown defense. I think Eduard Folayang ticked every single box in our judging categories.
World champion, the heavyweight champ, Brandon Vera.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Eduard Folayang!
Folayang in the red trunks, Perudinov in the black, Russia versus the Philippines. Could we see a contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night? Folayang, the Wushu specialist. Perudinov undefeated, 15-0. Folayang looks for the outside thigh early.
You can see the difference just in their stances alone. Folayang's very relaxed, very comfortable on his feet. You can see Aziz almost looks a little bit awkward standing in front of Folayang.
Perudinov, usually an explosive starter. 11 wins in the very first round for the Russian.
He just overwhelms his opponents, Michael. He hurts them, backs them up, and then just punishes them on the ground. But Folayang's so tough to hit. His head is made of concrete, almost impossible to knock down.
Folayang, step up sidekick. The sidekick, one of the specialties of the Wushu martial artists, and Folayang uses it well. Folayang goes body, goes breadbasket, goes outside flanking. Outside flanking again, Perudinov looks for a counter right hand.
I like how Folayang's attacking that lower leg. It's gonna hurt the movement of Perudinov, and he's gonna just start to get stationary.
Folayang's got to be careful, though. When he throws the outside leg, he puts a drop. He's left hand. But Perudinov has to come out of the top with a counter right.
Perudinov looked for a double leg takedown, but we saw a very heavy sprawl from the landslide. Perudinov's got to create a little bit more of a distraction. Throw his hands first before shooting in like that.
Folayang tucking the chin, looking through the brow. Step across inside thigh kick to that femoral profunda. Perudinov circling dangerously into Folayang's power side.
Look at the head movement of Folayang. He's never in that center line. He's constantly drifting his head from left and right, looking for his next big shot.
Inside leg kick again from Folayang. Just above the lead knee, and already you see below the hem of the trunks of Perudinov. It is tenderized. It is all shades of red. Again, Folayang hits the same spot, and another cutting side kick. Folayang is very good at doing that, at choosing a spot on the legs, on the body, and putting it over and over and over again to break his opponent down.
Cage. Look at the balance of Folayang on display.
The Sambo champion, Perudinov, would love to get this match to the ground. And Folayang's going to go through
the Russian to scoop up Folayang like that and put him onto his belly. Now he's got the back.
Belly to back here from the Russian. Throws him into the hamstring. Another one there for Perudinov for that sciatic.
See if Folayang can create a little bit of separation on those hands. Got to break that grip. Right now, Perudinov's got a very dominant controlling grip right there. He's got to separate those hands and spin into it.
Perudinov not letting go here. Folayang trying to get out of the
trick. And he does. He spins into it. Perudinov hitting the outside trick. Good defense from Folayang.
Overhook on the right arm there. Out from Folayang.
Sambo background, rolling Folayang onto his back. Now he's in the half guard. That was a very close round, so that maybe that takedown is going to give him the edge in this round. Let's see if he can advance his position and show a little bit of ground control.
Wrist control there from Perudinov. Gives up on that. Inside the feet, down to Folayang. Folayang will drag it over to the collarbone. Not allowing Perudinov to posture up and work the ground and back.
Touch here.
Yes.
You see Folayang trying to overhook those arms, control a little bit of the grounding pound coming from Perudinov. But Perudinov's got to do a little bit more in this round. You can't just hold your opponent down. Just because you're on top does not mean you are winning the exchange. You've got to do damage, show aggression, try to advance your position.
Oh, he's got it here from Folayang. He opens it up now. Big rock between the eyes from Perudinov. Slings a monster for Russian, bringing it home stronger. And we've got ourselves a match and a half. Here inside the massive ball of Asia Arena, where we are sold out for one championship reign of King.
That was a tale of very two different areas of mixed martial arts. We saw the, like, look at Folayang, how relaxed and comfortable he was, picking apart that leg, doing damage to the leg, and controlling a lot of the exchange. But look, watch, when things went to the clinch and the ground, Perudinov starts to shine. Look at this, going for a high crotch and just putting Folayang onto his belly, controlling the back. Folayang was able to posture back up, but Perudinov was able to take him down again and continue the aggression in that ground exchange.
A heavyweight champion of the world, Grand Imperial. It's the hottest ticket in town. It's one championship reign of kings. Second round between the former world champion, Eduard Folayang, and the World Cup Sambo champion, Aziz Perudinov. Russia versus the Philippines. Been a great run for the Philippines so far. They have been undefeated. Wins by Rene Catalan, Joshua Pascio. Now hoping here for Eduard Folayang.
Edward wants to do this, he's got to stay away from the clinch up against the cage and keep this match in the middle of the cage, right here, doing what he does best, and that's throwing those big old hands.
Every time Folayang comes close to predicting his crowd, ooze and arms and massive.
You can see Perudinov starting to gingerly step on that leg. Folayang's got to go after that leg again. Look at the calf.
Deafening chance going up again for Eduard Folayang. Looks for the inside leg. Folayang nicely cuts off the cage. Left hook there from Perudinov. And Folayang stops the takedown attack.
Perudinov knows where he needs to get this match, and he needs to get it to the ground because that leg, that's starting to bother him. Look how he's moving. He's stepping gingerly on it. Folayang should go back to that leg kick, attack that calf again.
Look for a step-up side kick there. Did Folayang, controlling since again. Sprawls out, defends the takedown attempt. Belly to back now from the Russian.
Beautiful combination. Went for the double leg, transitions to the back. Ooh, Folayang able to get away.
A very martial arts savvy crowd here in Manila. Appreciating everything they're seeing from Eduard Folayang here at the moment. 3:10 remains, second round. Folayang, that right hand is cocked and ready. Perudinov drifting into the right hand, dangerously so. High right roundhouse kick from the Russian. Skip across inside, thigh kick there from Folayang. Jab two, that two went to the body. Inside leg kick from Folayang. It's worked a treat for him so far. And now that reddening on the inside thigh has turned a shade of purple, a kaleidoscope of color. Folayang fakes, not so the jab. Misses with the outside leg kick. There's the left hand, that didn't miss.
Perudinov needs to start checking that leg kick or at least turn his shin out a little bit just to prevent some of this damage. Because like you said, Folayang likes to get a weakness and then start to exploit it.
Skip up inside leg kick again from Folayang. 2 minutes remaining, second round of three. Folayang.
Thank you.
20 seconds remaining in this round. A front kick there from Folayang.
Good evasion by Putinov to sidestep that push kick.
Inside looking again from Edward. What a round from the former world champion.
Look at this. In this, that this match, this round was all that. Leg kick after leg kick, inside, going to the outside. Folayang keeping it in the middle of the cage. But look at this. Picks up Perudinov and puts him on his backside and throws a punch just for good measure. Look at that. The spinning back kick. Folayang still ain't afraid to spin and goes right to the liver with the turning back kick. Big round for Folayang. Aziz Perudinov's got to come out with a massive third round if he wants to keep that perfect record intact.
Third and final round. This cauldron of an arena all behind Eduard Folayang of the Filipino.
He's immediately shoots in for the single leg. Let's see if he can do with it.
Perudino does not want to take any more of a striking standing up from Folayang. And lead there from Perudino.
Edward uses the cage, gets back up against it, dives underneath, trying to get his back pressed up against the cage, to turn to go belly-belly.
High lean from Perudino, to strike the discus of Folayang. This crowd on the edge of their seats. All those watching live on ABS-CBN Sports in action here in the Philippines, at home, in the bars, wherever they are. I'm sure they're screaming, jumping up and down for Eduard Folayang, the national hero.
Look at Bruno's leg. He has to hyperextend and almost lock it out so the leg doesn't buckle, just to keep pushing.
That lead leg looks like it's melting. And another cutting side kick there from Folayang. Perudinov did come in 15-0, but as we said earlier, he has never faced anyone like the former world champion, Eduard Folayang. Say 20-0 on a 15-match winning streak. He does have one draw on his record. Perudinov. Inside leg kick. A nice step around inside leg that has worked a treat for Folayang. And there's the cutting side kick once more. The wushu technique for Folayang. Aoki to win the World Lightweight Championship back on November 11, 2016, before losing it to Martin Nguyen in November of last year. Defeated the undefeated Karen Ngediev last time out in May. And maybe 2.5 minutes away from defeating another undefeated Russian in Aziz Perudinov here tonight. Perudinov shoots in, Folayang scores out. The landslide in the red in control. Ducks up with a right hand counter.
Let's go.
Inside leg kick of beauty. So to the back leg. Those tenderized thighs of the Russian. His legs will be throbbing. They'll be heavy. They'll be all sorts of sore.
It's going to be a painful plane ride back to Dagestan. You were right, Michael. Once Folayang gets a target, he is relentless with it. Look at him, takedown defense right here. Oh, man, Puma able to get him down as he tries to work past guard.
Is this the chance that Perunov needs? Top position with 135 remaining. Close guard for Folayang. Opens it up now to the Filipino.
You see him trying to go for Kimura. He was trying to play with that arm. He pushed the arm down, go for a triangle. Smart job by Folayang to try to control that wrist right there. But Pruninov's keeping it nice and tight. He knows what Folayang's trying to do.
Folayang came in on a 6-week count. Aziz on a 7-week count. Both men knew it would be tough. Both men suggested they would be a decision. Keeps the Russian inside his guard.
He's trying to use a sweep there. Almost caught it, too. Active guard shown by Folayang.
Dragon, what does Perunov need to do with 40 seconds remaining?
He's got to pass the guard and work for a submission. That's his only chance. His leg has been brutalized all match. And Folayang has rocked the punch. But now he's got a chance to do something here. Good spin. Maybe take the back, jump on, go for a rear naked choke. Folayang's wise to it, turns in, goes belly to belly, he's going to create a little bit of separation here.
Is there something left for Perunov? Is there one big silver for the Russian? We're in the final seconds now. This crowd sets a victory for Eduard Folayang. They can arrange the roof. To help him stay standing.
Just once he found the target, he went to it over and over again. I like the setup there. He kept going to the leg, he mixes things up, he goes to the head. As he's coming around, he throws that patented spinning back fist. Good performance from the Landslide, Eduard Folayang.
Wherever you're watching, 138 countries around the world, live on the One Super App. How did you score it, Folayang or Perunov? Let's go to Dominic Lau to find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner, by unanimous decision.
Of the eye, the jerking of the neck. It's the Tourette syndrome that Amir Khan has had all his life. The pro golfer hoping to become Singapore's first ever homegrown world champion.
When I asked him about it, he says he never takes his eyes off opponents despite it. You know, the fans in here, they may have paid for the entire seat here at the Mall of Asia Arena, but they're only going to need the edge of that seat tonight, Michael Schmello.
The familiar Team Lakai red trunks with the Filipino flag for Eduard Folayang, the former world's champion. Hard left roundhouse kick out of southpaw stance for Khan. He's got the most knockouts in one championship history. Folayang's got that wushu style, those powerful side kicks. Amir Khan is a Muay Thai stylist.
Switches stances very well. He floats between southpaw and orthodox effortlessly. He mixes in a lot of different styles. Oh, look at Folayang spinning already.
Both men coming close there. The high kick from Khan, the spinning back fist from Folayang. Outside low kick, Folayang needs to bring the hands up afterwards, not to get counted. Celebrated his birthday yesterday, Eduard Folayang. Will he be given the gift of reclaiming championship gold? Big outside leg kick. There's the counter from Khan I spoke about. Folayang must keep his hands up when he strikes.
Jack came off very fast.
Khan can knock you out from anywhere. He doesn't need much room. Could knock you out in a phone booth. The Singaporean checks the low kick, goes for the counter down the center corridor.
Khan seems very content to stay in orthodox. He's timing his jabs nicely. He's closing the distance very fast with that right hand as well.
Khan, switch up roundhouse kick from the Singaporean. Inside leg kick misses the target. He loaded fully up on that, did Eduard Folayang.
Fully committed to these shots, Michael Schiavello. Without a little bit of distance, they blitz in, they blitz out. Oh, Khan goes after him, but look at that takedown from Eduard Folayang. He's in the guillotine.
Guillotine attempt here for the Neo Khan. No avail though. On the floor for the first time. 2:20 remaining. First round. Now back on the feet. Out of the guillotine attempt goes for Lyon. Throws a knee to the upper left rib cage of Khan. Then goes down to the thigh. And once more to the thigh from Folayang. A real tussle against the wire here.
They've got 50-50 position. Each one has an underhook. Each one has an overhook. Now, look for the knees. Watch Folayang's knees. He's an expert. His hips are back. He's pressing off the cage with his butt so he can create a little bit of space to deliver those knees. Now he's got Khan up against the cage.
Break off. Some room for Khan to work his high kicks perhaps.
Looks to pack down a little bit of muscles as the last time we saw him. He's looking really thick.
Folayang, little flicking back fist there as Khan was almost off balance. Front kick from the Singaporean. Folayang resets center of the cage. 1:25 remains now in the first round. We are set for five for the lightweight championship of the world. A pinch up again, drive Folayang back against the cage. Couple of knees off the right leg there from a former world champion.
Khan likes that overhand right as Folayang's missing it. Khan's lunging forward, throwing that big right hand. Folayang's been able to evade it so far. A little bit of time spent up that cage. The reversal by Khan is in the crowd.
Chance to add Folayang here in Manila, the sold out Mall of Asia Arena. It's one championship conflict of champions.
Knee landed by Khan, but you can see Folayang didn't like it. He's a little more cautious. Look at him guarding the hips with those hands.
Nice knee again to the midsection, trying to fold him in half like a piano accordion.
That was the plan of Khan. Go to the body early. Hurt him with push kicks and knees inside the clinch.
Some distance now for both men to get their strikes off. Who will land first with 20 seconds to go in the round? Front kick from Khan. Southpaw stance on the Singaporean. Looks for the inside leg, does Folayang. Oh, and cutting Wushu's side kick to the lead thigh. An outside crescent kick, a little left hand over the top. Combination from Folayang. Spinning back kick, how do you do? There's the end of round one.
Wow, very close round. A lot of very, very close counters. You can see as one exchanges, the other one comes right back. The first part of that round was a lot of posturing, but look at this. Watch, boom, big leg kick landed by Folayang. Khan saw that counter. He's starting to counter very well with those punches. He's waiting for Folayang to kick, and he's attacking the head with the punches. Then he starts going to the body. He's watched that rear push kick from Khan going to the body, and then watch the knees inside the clinch up against the cage. Inside that clinch, you can see Folayang started to protect his body from those knees with putting his hands on Amir's hips just so he created a little bit of separation and also judge that distance. The second round, watch for Amir Khan to increase the volume of kicks that go to the body. He might even start throwing in the roundhouse off of the switch.
Amir Khan said 100% I finished Folayang inside of three rounds. Folayang with this massive crowd behind him. Second round, the lightweight world title. Inside leg kick from the former champion. Highlight round there, caught in the forearms. Folayang inching forward. Sets himself a lot lower in his stance than Khan. Good side kick, that one aimed to the liver section.
Khan's got to do something about that push kick. He's got to start stepping off to the side.
Big left hook there, smack bang from Folayang. And Khan does a quick count of his teeth. When Eduard explodes, Mitch, he can explode.
He comes out so fast. He throws that left kick. And look at that switch. He comes so
side kick to the midsection, but it's a little low.
It looked a little bit low. It could have been seen as low, but Khan seems okay. Khan's not going to disrupt his rhythm. He's trying to find a rhythm. He's trying to disrupt Edward's rhythm. And he's okay.
Folayang looks like he's got a bit of pepper about him here in the second round. Throwing the strikes, got the output, got the work rate. Time for Amir Khan to pick up the pace now. Outside leg kick, missed the target from Folayang. Goes back to center cage, drifts off to his left. Stiff jab there from Khan, that was a beauty.
Like that jab, he's got to do more of that. He can't allow Folayang to start throwing target practice.
Folayang remaining high on the balls of his feet now. Looking very spry. Khan thrust the jab out again. Maybe needs a right roundhouse kick for company after that left jab. Beautiful Wushu kick again there from Folayang. Looks for the inside thigh, goes to the body, picks him up, tries to put him down, but Khan maintains his vertical status.
I'd like to see Khan start going after the legs of Folayang. Start throwing those jabs and then just putting a little bit of a leg kick on, just so if this does go into the later rounds, four or five rounds, that, you know, the movement's not quite so explosive for Folayang, because he can do this for 25 minutes, no problem. Khan's got to slow him down. Go back to the body. He's getting away from his game plan.
The Philippines currently own four world championships at one championship. Can Eduard Folayang make it five out of a possible eight? That would be an incredible national achievement. Switching stance again. Khan just gets out of the way. That wicked left hook of Folayang. It is sharp and fast. Inside leg kick from Folayang. The tension here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. You just get the feeling that at any moment something could happen. Plenty of action from Folayang. Little puppy rock hand on the inside. Overhook of that left arm from Amir Khan.
Momentum is starting to shift in Folayang's favor. Now he's got him pressed up against the cage. Khan's got to see how he attacks him. He presses him up against the cage. So Khan can't separate the hips. He's not able to deliver those knees with the same amount of force, because his hips are pressed up against the cage. Watch Folayang get pressed up against the cage.
Oh, spinning back fist! Inside leg kick. Here comes Folayang. Here comes the landslide. Amir closes him down. Oh, spinning back fist again. It is champagne from Folayang.
Canvas.
of utter craziness inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. Third round of five. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, in particular, all of our fans here in the Philippines on ABS-CBN Sports in Action, in Singapore, Octo Sports Toggle. On the edge of your seats, no doubt, cheering on these two tremendous martial arts warriors.
See, this is what happens. Ev Ting is starting to get more and more comfortable on his feet. Khan has to change the direction of this match. He's got to shoot him for takedowns. He's got to get Folayang to think about something else besides just the striking, because that is Folayang's world.
Amir Khan trying to wind up the roundhouse kick. He's found so much success with it in the past. Third round of five. What is Khan thinking right now? He took some heavy strikes in the second round. A lesser man would have gone down, but not Amir Khan. Folayang tries for the overhand right. Arm taking his time. Tucks the chin, looks through the brow. Folayang skips in for an inside throat kick. Adding side kick to the lead thigh there from Folayang, showing that wushu styling. What should Khan be looking for here, Mitch?
He tried to throw that big overhand right. Folayang saw it coming, was able to get out the way. Khan's got to spin around now, press him up against the cage, try to take him down. He's only just standing there. He's gotten away from his game plan. He's not throwing the body kicks. He's not attacking the legs of Folayang. He's just now going headhunting with the punches. Khan's got to change things up a little bit. Look at this pressure of Folayang driving the head into the chin.
Khan climbs towards his corner, tries to pull the head down for the meet and greet knee. Both men reset. Under 3 minutes remaining in the third round. Khan goes high. Folayang goes low. Fakes there from Amir Khan, out of southpaw starts.
He's got to put some combinations together. Right now, see, just one punch, one kick. Folayang can see that stuff coming. You got to set him up.
Folayang, double forearms guard against the left roundhouse kick. This crowd has gone silent on the edge of their seats here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. If Folayang lands again like he did in the second, they will raise the roof. Takedown to the former champion! To the feet goes Khan, trying to lock up a choke attempt. That's out the head for Folayang. My word, Folayang is looking sharp. But there is still a long time to go. Khan has youth on his side.
Nice elbow from the clinch. He was able to connect with that right elbow.
Folayang showing that older age shall not weary him. Khan sets the left roundhouse kick here. Chose to go the rear hand instead. Switches stance now to orthodox as Amir Khan. Is he going to go the right roundhouse kick?
He's going to attack the leg with that kick.
Stiff jab. Tried to catch Folayang coming in. Folayang fakes off the lead. Gotta make sure he keeps his hands up here, Edward. Toe-to-toe now. Khan switches back to southpaw, now back to orthodox. Trying to confound Folayang. Trying to mix it up, keep it fresh. Folayang rushes him back against the wire now. Throws a corking knee.
Control. Watch how Edwards controlling the left hand there of Khan. Khan, good circle out.
Big left hand. Oh, and another one. Folayang lands a double left hook.
Khan right there on the right side. You can see that mouth starting to lift under the eye.
The right hand. The high kick. The right hand again. And the crossing elbow. Edward Folayang. More combinations than a Sudoku puzzle. What a performance! champion. Catches a roundhouse kick and came agonizingly close there for Khan. Avid southpaw start for the Singaporean. Spinning back fist from Folayang. Khan drive in against the wire. Final seconds of the round. Both men throwing knees on the inside. This is how the round ends.
Eduard Folayang is starting to inch ahead. He found a lot of combinations that found success. Look at this, there was that punch coming. He was able to avoid it, goes right underneath, secures the very aggressive takedown from Khan. But Khan was able to scramble, trying to control with the front headlock, but Folayang was able to get back up to his feet. Again, look at that beautiful duck under, over the top. Left hand, Folayang's mixing in the weapons well. Khan has got to change something he's doing. Right now he's only boxing. He's got to get back to the body kicks. He's got to attack the legs. He's got to mix things up a little bit, at least start to circle off, to create angles, and not just go forward and back. Folayang is really putting things together. He's mixing his kicks extremely well with his punches.
We go into what they call the championship round. The 4 for 5 for the lightweight championship of the world. Eduard Folayang, Amir Khan. Youth on the side of Khan. Experience on the side of the former world champion Folayang. Khan looks for an early takedown. Folayang stops the attempt. Right in front of our commentary position now. Tandrel against the wire, knee there from Folayang, doubles up on it.
See, that's how good Folayang is in the clinch. Even when he's being pressed up against the cage, he still finds a way to create a little bit of space with his hips and throw those knees. Look at that, 3, 4 unanswered knees, 5 knees now that have all landed to the body. Even inside the clinch, he's very dangerous with those knees because of those little subtle ways he's able to find that space and land those knees.
Muay Thai stylist Amir Khan would love to lock on that Muay Thai clinch. Not going to happen at the moment, though. Oh, spinning back fist, caught him on the orbital. Beautifully done there from Folayang. Turning like a tornado. Fires out the left kick.
The third time he's been able to exit and throw a spinning back elbow. Every time he clinches up the cage, he lands the knees, softens up the body, and then Khan starts to drop his hands. Folayang spinning back elbow. Third time he's done it. Good job by Khan. Now he's starting to threaten the takedowns. But the takedown defense of Folayang is so good. He gets the underhooks, presses Khan up against the cage. Now he's attacking the legs for the takedown zone.
Into the end zone thigh from Folayang. Looks for the horizontal elbow.
Look for the elbow. Watch, he's controlling the hand right here. There's one elbow. Let's see if he spins. He can't spin because of the underhook on the left side.
Oh, those elbows slicing up. Amir Khan. Cut under the right eye of Khan.
See, now he can spin. Now he can spin with the right side. Yep. Chooses to go right up the middle.
Uppercut elbow from Eduard Folayang. It's all coming off the right arm of the Filipino. Tries to put the chin through the top of the head. The heavy artillery from Eduard Folayang. Amir's face showing the signs of those punishing Folayang elbows. Wants to sink a choke here on Folayang. Folayang puts the head up, lands another left hook.
That's the biggest difference, Michael, that I've seen in Eduard Folayang so far is up against the cage. That clinch is doing damage up against the cage. This is a completely new element from Eduard Folayang. This is not something he's had. The way he's damaging, little tiny shots. Oh, big head kick.
That's 2 high kicks in a row. The game terrifyingly close for Amir Khan. Folayang's got to keep that right glove glued to the side of his face.
That's not his style. He doesn't really protect that head. He likes to relax. He likes to flow. See how that hand keeps drifting down?
Folayang breathing a little heavier now. 4th round of 5. Gets out of the way of that high lift round. Slow down a little Folayang. Can Amir Khan capitalize? He's got the youth, Khan. Folayang sets the right hand here. Rips off. Wushu kick to the lead leg. Circling into the power side, though, of Amir Khan. Folayang. Both men trade, and it was Khan who drew the shots. Just spinning hook kick! The acrobatics from Eduard Folayang. What about that side kick downstairs? 1 minute remaining, 4 for 5. Catch of the roundhouse kick there from Folayang. Southpaw starts here now on Amir Khan. Now switches back to orthodox. Folayang, go watch those turnarounds. That's what Martin Ewing caught him on when he got knocked out last time. Spinning back fist, duck under there from Amir Khan. Looks the inside leg, just Folayang.
Like, see him shoot for a takedown, his guys. Spinning, but he's doing such a good job at defending the takedown so far. Khan's got to keep starting kicking again. He's got to attack those legs. Folayang's movement hasn't slowed at all.
Spinning kick, inside thigh kick from Folayang. What's a beauty. Final seconds of the fourth. We're going into the fifth. The deepest of deep water. Amir Khan has never been here before. Eduard Folayang has many times. How will that factor into things? Amir Khan, never been to fight.
Let's watch Folayang do work up against that cage. The little subtleties that he's bringing to his game have completely changed. Watch this. He creates a little bit of space there with his hips, right? Boom, lands one knee. Boom, there's another knee. Look how he opens up the arm of Khan and lands those knees. Then he forces the arm down, gets Khan fighting the arm. Boom, comes right up top with a beautiful over the top. There's that spinning heel kick. Changes it up, changes the direction of the foot. So normally you throw the heel up, but then he hit him with the palm of his face. The three champions directly behind us. The strawweight, the bantamweight, and the flyweight world champions want another belt to take home to Baguio. Do they have enough space in their luggage, Michael Schiavello?
Here we go, the fifth and final round. Tension in the air. Can the Philippines claim fifth world champion here at One Championship? Khan comes out of his corner quickly. Throws the high lift around. That's his prime weapon. Shoots him for a double. Sprawl out there from Folayang.
Takedown defense has gotten so much better. Khan's usually been able to take opponents down, but Folayang leveled up.
Wrist control, both men jousting for it. Spinning back elbow from Folayang, then goes down to the thigh. Crossing elbow from Folayang. Overhook on the arm for Amir Khan. Wants to sink a choke of the Filipino. Folayang defends against it. And they break off. Let's see if Khan gets the roundhouse kick off the right leg here. Folayang drifting into it. Overhand right from Khan. Will Khan switch back to southpaw stance? There's the high left roundhouse out of southpaw, now back to orthodox. Shoots in, another takedown defense from Folayang. Overhooks the right arm.
Takedowns and takedown defenses score the same, so Folayang is scoring with all these takedown defenses beautifully. It's that cage control we were talking about at the beginning. Folayang takes this match where he wants to. If he wants to keep it on the feet, that's where he does it. If he wants to keep him up against the cage, Folayang keeps him up against the cage. If he wants to keep it in the dead center, he's doing it.
Mitch Amir Khan's mouth open here. Is the younger combatant fatigued in the fifth and final round?
I believe so. Folayang has never gotten tired. Look at him, still throwing the heat with the feet.
You train at those high altitudes in Baguio City. One thing all Team Lakai has is cardio for days.
But not just training at high altitude, it's the work rate that these guys put out. It's constant. They do so much conditioning, so much training. They're such highly refined athletes in every sense of the word.
Nice elbow there from Folayang off the left arm.
Watch the elbow. See how he controls the hand? Boom, he pins down the hand and comes up with the elbow. Look at that.
slicing and dicing with the elbows on the inside. The former world champion. 2 minutes 35 remains, fifth and final.
Those are little shots, but man, they are paying such dividends right now. He's controlling the clinch so well.
Jab two attempt there from Folayang. Khan's got to go, and he's got to go soon. It may be time to throw caution to the wind and pull out all the stops for Amir Khan. Folayang, ooh, that came close, a matter of millimeters. Jab there from Folayang, uppercut from Khan, a right hand from Folayang. Folayang gets out of the way of the jab. Orthodox stance for Khan, who has switched the entire contest. Folayang goes to the outside lead leg. Spinning heel kick! That came close to shin. I should say heel to neck. And that connects. It's good night for Khan. Uppercut from Khan, nicely done. There's a jab from the Singaporean. Is he going to get his second wind here with 1:30 remaining?
I think we're looking at his fourth wind right now, Michael. He's trying to push forward. He's trying to keep hunting. But look at Folayang going for the takedown. Good defense from Khan, though.
Khan stays vertical. We're moving towards the final minute on this world title bout. Khan glances towards his corner.
Elbow again!
Tried to shave the moustache off. 1 minute now. Are we going down to the judges, or will we see a finish in the final 60 seconds? It has been a champagne performance from Eduard Folayang. But Khan is not done yet. He will not wave the white flag. He will not go quietly into the night.
A sidekick! Another one!
Folayang showing the wusha. Dropped down for a single leg, didn't have it. Pitches upstairs. Khan tried to pull the head down. Jab to Folayang. And there's the hook afterwards.
3 seconds left.
As Khan shot in reserve here.
Is he going to be flying kick?
Eduard Folayang in the dying stages with the acrobatics. Folayang bringing it home. Folayang with the side kicks and the spinning kicks. This one's for the Philippines. This one's for the nosebleeds. Emotional scenes, standing ovation here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. What a performance from Eduard Folayang to turn on the acrobatics in the final 30 seconds, to stuff the takedowns, attempts of Amir Khan. Victor Kui to present the championship belt. My word, extraordinary world title match. Sellout crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Millions watching around the world, especially here in the Philippines on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. Is there about to be an outpouring into the streets of Baguio City? Is the party in the high altitude about to begin? Or will Singapore get its first ever homegrown world champion? Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner.
Champion again! famous martial artist. Amasana, 5-1, 60% finishing rate. As Mitch said, one last run at the title for Eduard Folayang. It starts tonight. Amasana, back-to-back wins over Shannon Guruchai and Orgul Bataku, both by decision. Look out for the legs. The wushu stylings of Folayang, the cutting side kicks and the roundhouse kicks. Also the spinning back kicks. Two first round finishes for Amasana. Seven first round finishes for Folayang. The last one was way back in 2012. A 56 second win over Watson Teixeira.
Wings immediately starting to go out to the legs of Amra. Trying to slow down the footwork and the movement, and also the ability to deliver those power shots. Amara likes to come forward with that big right hand. He's gonna have to plant that left leg and do it. So you can start to see Folayang starting to touch up that lower part of the leg. And you can see how Amara is just kind of lifting up a little bit, taking a little bit of pressure off.
Amara has three knockouts in five outings, but his last KO was in September 2016 against Dasko Nakamura. Hook kick you saw there. Roundhouse kick, trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck.
Mixing up the weapons real good. He's going after the legs, the body, and the head.
Folayang, a member of the Philippine Wushu team, multi-time gold medalist.
Oh, that left hand touched him. Exactly. Stop the head.
Oh, the sidekick! Trying to cut him home! And a front kick from us to Amasada. Folayang fights. Resets. The Filipino in the red. The Mongolian in the green and black.
Folayang looking spectacular in the early stages of this first round. He's putting some serious heat behind these punches and these kicks. We've only seen Folayang outstruck once, and that was from Martin Nguyen, who slept him with that beautiful right hand as Folayang was caught mid-spin. Rarely ever see anybody outstrike Folayang on the feet. He moves around effortlessly. Beautiful movement.
Side kick again. Nice little step up there. Turn back and forth for Folayang. Suddenly kick just below the left knee. Folayang, the man who Pacquiao called one of the legends of Philippines mixed martial arts. Pacquiao was with Eduard Folayang when Folayang first won the world title against Shuga Aoki.
Folayang is susceptible to the shots. He's got to be careful inside those close range exchanges. You can see Amr start to wildly swing those punches right after a shot from Folayang. Folayang's got to keep that chin nice and tucked. He doesn't want to pop with the chin up in the air.
Folayang made his pro debut way back in 2007. Amasana in 2016 went 3-0 before his first loss to Koji Takeda in deep. Amasana will like to switch stance between orthodox and southpaw. Takes an inside thigh kick in southpaw stance. Right hand cocked and ready here for Folayang. It's off to his left. Away from the power side of Amasana. Inside leg kick from Folayang. There's the right hand down the tube. Patience here from Eduard Folayang. The man they call Landslide. Heels of Bangkok City, north of Manila, as a cutting side kick to the guts. There's one to the thigh. That's the wushu stylings of Folayang.
Filipino's got to close the distance. He's got to try to get inside these kicks. He does not want to stay at the end of his foot range.
A red brown husky from Folayang. And a look to it. Ooh, from the sold-out audience inside the Mall of Asia Arena.
Doing good work on that lead leg. Amra switching stances, mixing up the lead leg stance, but it doesn't matter what leg is forward.
Oh, spinning hook kick! How do you do? I like real stuff from Eduard Folayang. And another cutting side kick. Stops Amasana on his tracks. More kick with a corner slide for Eduard Folayang in the first round.
spinning hook kick. Absolute kicking finish from Eduard Folayang.
We said it was a battle of the weapons. It was the hands of Umra against the feet of Folayang, and right now the feet are running away with it. Beautifully timed. Everything is connected. The only thing that's missing are these head kicks, because Umra's got his hands glued to the side of his face. Folayang did good work with the leg kicks, also starting to attack the body as well with the side kicks. Just putting together a clinic of kicking. Look at that beautiful wraps. It goes around the guard, touches him on the side of the head. Beautiful work from the former champion. Even spinning, catching him with the side of the calf and the inside of the hamstring. All sorts of different weapons. There's the heavyweight king, Brandon Berry, in the house to support his fellow Filipinos.
And a roll there for Brandon Berry, heavyweight champion. Second round of three. Eduard Folayang and Amasana Saguka sold out inside the Mall of Asia Arena, the hottest ticket in town. Army night, right. Friday night in Manila.
Go.
It's one championship. Folayang, such an inspiration, raised in tragic circumstances. Had five of his siblings pass away due to illness, Eduard Folayang. Inspiration, top in the martial arts world. Real team leader, the big brother of Team Lakai. Jumping knee! Amasana gets airborne. Eduard ties him up. Ting goes back into the corner. Nice knee there on the inside. Doubles up with the right leg for Folayang. A chance for Amasana to use his hands. Still clinched up. Still working the knees. What's Amasana trying to do here, Dragon?
He's trying to change things up. He does not want to stay at the end of his kicks. Different area of the mixed martial arts game, and that's inside the clinch. He's got to step inside. He's got to commit a little bit to more and let those hands go. He's got beautiful boxing. I like to use it more. He's got to get past those kicks of Folayang.
Shots go up, Folayang. Folayang inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Track and roundhouse kick to the lower left rib cage and a cutting side kick, top of the thigh from Folayang. Has absolutely schooled and owned Amasana with the kicking arsenal. Amasana needs to let his hands go. The Mongolian machine packs tremendous power. Can't get on the inside of the kicks of Folayang at the moment.
I mean, you gotta ask yourself, does the crowd and does this energy that Folayang is receiving affect Amra? But I don't think it's gonna affect him too much. He spent most of his career competing against Japanese competitors in Japan, so he's used to going into enemy territory.
I'll beg to differ there, Mitch. He's competed in front of big crowds in Japan, but they're silent in Japan. They're loud here in Manila. And now
he's hurt.
He's got a fresh breath. Now he's got some gusto. Inside of half guard, the crown and pound of Folayang. And Folayang controlling the posture. Folayang is cut open. Amasana drills a knee. Folayang in trouble. Folayang in trouble.
They're going to stop and take a, have a doctor look at it.
Folayang's been opened up here.
That's the power of the hands of Amra. You give him the slightest opening, he's going to step in and he's going to hurt you with those hands. Let's see what it was. I think it was a clash.
Accidental.
It was the head, and it, you could see it immediately open up a huge, just a cut right up below the left eye of Folayang as this crowd reacts. If we're at the halfway point of the match, we'll go to the judges' scorecards. If we're not quite at the halfway point, it'll be ruled a no contest. Okay, so it looks like we have passed by 1 second the halfway point of the match.
So if Eduard Folayang cannot continue, it will go to a technical decision. Let's go to Tom.
Ladies and gentlemen, due to an unintentional foul, this match will now turn to the judges' scorecards for a technical decision. all three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner.
Absolutely deafening. Eduard Folayang takes the decision.
Guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.